Why is it the year 2024 and we have a TED TV show? Now, how weird is it that the show is actually good?
A couple of deep breaths here and just try to...
Can you believe it's been almost 2 years since I last talked about the surprise reveal of a TED TV series? Based off the hit film franchise created by the funny family man himself, Seth MacFarlane. Gotta be honest, I did not think this thing was coming out. We barely heard a thing about it until like a month ago. Being a Peacock original also didn't give me much confidence that this wouldn't be canceled the second the executives realized they have about 24 subscribers on the service. I only bought it to watch this show, and in writing that, I just reminded myself to go cancel it. But again, I was not optimistic. TED was one of my favorite childhood movies, showcasing a little kid having his Christmas wish be granted with his teddy bear coming to life. Only to fast forward 30 years where the charm of him has vanished and they're just sitting around smoking pot all day. John having to learn to let this literal manifestation of his childhood go, as it's harming the relationships he makes as an adult. And then the second is just about Ted trying to prove he can have a kid or something. The villain from the first one returns. They sing Sweet Caroline. I think that's the only joke worth remembering. Ted has aged kind of poorly in my opinion. I feel like every time I revisit it, I'm still able to acknowledge that it is good. You know, the plot is great. I love the characters. The animation holds up extremely well. But the humor, man, hilarious in some cases. But Seth's over-reliance on pop culture and name-dropping in place of actual jokes has it starting to show its age.
That's my bad, I was sending a tweet.
You mean a zeet? Sorry. That was the one aspect of the series I was happy about. Ditching the concept of continuing where the sequel left off, and instead going back to when John and he were teenagers. Ted getting sent off to school with him having to deal with the awkward teen issues you'd expect, like doing drugs for the first time or finding a date to the prom. But thankfully, and honestly shockingly, I think the series manages to avoid a lot of the tired tropes you would anticipate from a setup like that, and instead uses it as a jumping ground to showcase a charming throwback to the 90s, exploring these characters through a lot of their first experiences with stuff that was so second nature to them in the film. And there's a talking teddy bear. And Sonic.
Oh, what about this? Sega Genesis.
I think what surprised me most about the series was their commitment to the Bennett family as a whole. The other members get just as much screen time as John and Ted. I'm sure Ted's animation being so expensive was undoubtedly a factor in that, but at the same time, I think it shows Seth's confidence in making endearing characters outside of the one you're obviously coming here for. We even have Steve Smith playing John's dad. He's the guy. The guy who says,
Baba Booey!
Other than that, there's John's mom who fills in the role of a traditional submissive wife. Something they explore a lot throughout the show, as well as his cousin who's staying with them. Despite only having 7 episodes, they did a solid job at mixing and matching them. They each all have at least one memorable moment with each other, which I was not expecting. The stars of the show, though, were of course John and Ted. At first, I was really not feeling the show. The first joke is literally just the same first joke from the movie. They both have the same theme song. I was really concerned this was just gonna be a soulless cash grab, retreading the same jokes and humor that the movie already did. I mean, they thought they could just call this Super Mario and we'd all just sit down and accept it? I won't. However, once they get into the story, it picks up drastically, with Ted being forced to go to school with John as they start to introduce you to more of this world and the new characters not present in the film, whether it be the girl he likes or stereotypical fat bully. They all have the pieces here for what should be every other high school show, but they somehow manage to avoid all the pitfalls you would expect. These characters aren't present throughout a majority of the series. It's not treated as some sort of ensemble. They only come into play once they have something interesting to do with them, and I think that's what I enjoyed most about this show. It's focused, and John and Ted's relationship feels genuine. I was not sure how well the kid who misses in Daddy Daycare could carry a show on his own.
What does that mean?
I missed.
Oh, hell no.
I feel like of course you'd assume that an adult actor with many more years of experience in the industry would help them be better when acting against nothing. Yeah, that's right. Sorry to any kids out there watching. Santa's not real, and neither is Ted. Mark Wahlberg did a fantastic job, and honestly, so did Max Burkholder. I can think of maybe one scene where it came off unnatural and it was in the final episode where he's meant to be chasing him. His movements feel like they have a 5-second delay to them. But other than that, I can't think of a single other moment where I didn't think Ted was there. Certainly thanks to Seth being a great voice actor in general, he does just as good of a job as he always does. I don't know what's up with you, Seth. You're a phenomenal actor, but when I see your face, I wanna punch it. Tried watching the first episode of The Orville and I just couldn't get past his smug-ass face. But in Ted, he's good. Thumbs up. What definitely adds to that is the animation. They seriously did not skimp on the quality here. There was one scene where he looked kinda out of place and it's when he was showering. We can send robot cars to Mars, but we can't figure out how to make good CG water. But again, other than that, he looks fantastic. Incredibly impressive for a TV production. I love his dumb little face, his blank expressions add so much unintentional comedy to every scene he's in. Speaking of comedy, I was really pleased to see that Ted stands out as one of the funniest things Seth has ever put out. Nothing had me rolling on the floor laughing or anything, but I did have a smile on my face for a majority of the runtime. It really reminded me of early Family Guy, especially in pacing and tone. Except instead of cutaways, most scenes wind up devolving into a short 30-second to minute-long rant or argument between characters, sometimes even having that go on throughout the rest of the scene as the others continue along with the story. Because of that, there are a couple times where I felt as if scenes were going on for too long, bordering on tedious. But for every joke that didn't land, there were about 5 others that did. I also enjoyed how earnest they aimed to make the show. The characters are at the core of every story, and it never diverts too much from what's at the center of every episode. Whether it be about his mom worrying that she's losing her husband, the cousin and Ted learning to bond, or even a right-wing toy truck coming to life and learning that he's only so bigoted because of his own closeted homosexuality. It all works in line with what you'd expect from these characters, somehow. On top of all that, it's simply just charming. It tries to be extremely edgy at times, but it never comes off like it's coming from a place of hatred or mockery. It all just feels so innocent and nice. The relationships with each other feel genuine. This is gonna be the worst comparison ever, and I'm only using it because they're both adult comedies releasing close to each other, but I want to quickly look at Ted compared to Hazbin Hotel.
Angel Dust.
No, I've only seen the first 2 episodes, so that's all I can speak on. But it's also a series that relies a lot on edgy humor. However, I couldn't put my finger on why Ted winds up achieving its earnest moments, whereas Hazbin, they always come off kinda out of place, like they didn't belong. And I think it has to do with balance and intent. Why does Ted doing a joke that doesn't rely on swearing or being edgy still manage to be funny?
Yeah, we will. Rum!
Hey, that looks fun.
Yeah, can we play?
No.
Ah.
Whereas Hazbin doing a joke that doesn't rely on those same things appears out of place. I can't show you the example I wanted to because the show isn't officially out yet and I don't want to show it, so like, okay, it's Charlie and she's entering a room nervously and a guy turns the light on which scares her, and which she trips over and they play a silly whimsical music like it's a fucking baby cartoon which doesn't fit her loudly proclaiming shit as she falls. Anyways, balance and intent. In Ted, its edginess is never the point of the scene, and I think that's the difference. And when it is, it's relevant to the story. Again, I look to the right-wing toy truck. It's never usually taking up screen time, and when it does, the joke is rarely just saying a curse word or saying something sexual. They usually build upon itself in a way that can only be done because it's those 2 characters talking. Each of them feel as if they have something unique to add. Their own spin and escalation on the joke. Not only is this funny, but it also naturally conveys to you how these characters are. You're not gonna have John's mom cursing or making edgy jokes or anything, but the way she reacts to the others doing so is how she gets to build upon this in a way only she can. Whereas in Hazbin, everyone feels interchangeable. Other than Angel Dust, I suppose, none of the jokes feel as if there's something only that character can say, which is usually just fuck. Or shit. Or cut. I feel like because of that, Ted is more able to earn those genuine moments because these characters feel real, like they're capable of being able to complete a sentence without needing to throw the word fuck in. Sorry, again, I know that's a strange comparison, but I watched these back to back. It was jarring. That's the closest thing to a Hazbin review you're ever gonna get out of me. My favorite episode of the Ted series would have to be the second one, where they kinda get rid of John's bully before even doing anything with him. This is by far the one that had me laughing the most. I could not get enough of Ted doing all this heinous shit with this most innocent smile on his face the whole way through. They learn that his bully doesn't have a dad in the picture anymore, and so they fucking decide to catfish him pretending to be his dad and asking to meet up, only to call him at the place they were meeting to tell him that he's a disappointment. But because these episodes are so long, they can go in multiple directions with it and build upon that. And so to make it up to him, they call him back as the dad apologizing, and through the phone calls get more and more genuinely invested in his life and want to find a way to continue following him along. It was pretty good. My least favorite, however, would probably have to be the 5th. I think it just takes way too long to get into it, with little to no payoff. Ted has to be the therapist for John's parents, where the mom realizes she gave up a lot of her own dreams for him. And so they just find a way to let her teach his class for a day, to which she leaves, saying she doesn't even want to be a teacher anymore, and that she likes being a stay-at-home mom. It takes them like 30 minutes to get through the therapist stuff, time which I feel like could have probably been put more towards the end of the episode, to actually go into her being fine with such a demeaning role. Just sort of felt like they needed to find a way to end it, but I definitely say there are more good ones here than bad. I like the Christmas and Halloween specials, they were alright. The pilot being John and Ted smoking weed for the first time was a fun idea, and the finale was pretty great too, concluding things in a natural way while still leaving things open for a potential season 2. Which I hope it gets! I was not expecting to come out of the TED show wishing for there to be more, but if anything else, I think this show is incredibly charming, and I simply like following these characters around in such a casual setting. I think what most have come to realize from this is that Seth MacFarlane is still a really funny guy that is capable of making something a quality. I think most forget that Seth hasn't been involved with Family Guy for more than half its life. It's evolved, or default, arguably, into something so removed from its initial vision, and most likely isn't where the series would be if the man were still with it to this day. But in other ways, I appreciate that he's decided to step away from that rotting corpse and has consistently tried to get out of his comfort zone and try a little bit of everything. So go check out the TED series! Somehow, I wouldn't recommend buying Peacock or anything, but I'm sure you'll find a way. You're clever. Oh, nice. Subscribe in the way I...